afternoon, viewers from Nairobi. Good afternoon, viewers from Zimbabwe. And a good afternoon, viewers from Africa and all over the whole world where you are watching me. This is Punchline Television, a special statement on Zimbabwe regarding George Soros' operations, regarding sanctions against Zimbabwe. This special report is brought after 18 years of struggle to remove sanctions against Zimbabwe, which were imposed by United States of America and some other countries. We have decided as Pan-African activists, freedom fighters of this continent, the people who have seen the suffering of the people of Zimbabwe in the last 18 years of sanctions. We are watching a situation where each day, each night, in the tropics of Africa, the people of Zimbabwe suffer as a result of illegal sanctions imposed by the United States hegemony on the government of Zimbabwe. Several resolutions have been passed from the African Union, SADC, East African Community, ECOWAS, some member states in United Nations asking for the removal of sanctions. The United States of America has not accepted to remove these sanctions. Each year, each administration has changed the goalposts in the removal of this, in this charade of sanctions against Zimbabwe. Zimbabwe is a rich country in Southern Africa. Zimbabwe has got its minerals, its resources. It can sustain itself. But the worst part of it is America tells them that they cannot use these resources. The worst part of it, the children are dying of malaria and other curable diseases that we can cure by buying medicines. People are dying of hunger. Yet the Zimbabweans are able to sell their resources to buy medicines, to buy essential goods, to buy petrol, to buy diesel, to buy paraffin, to use it in economic emancipation of their country. Time and time again, the West, especially America, has tried to use different tactics to install governments or puppet governments in Zimbabwe. They have used the George Soros as axis of evil to destabilize Zimbabwe and the rest of Africa. George Soros is a surrogate of the CIA mechanisms that disturb the entire world, whether in Hong Kong, in Addis Ababa today, in Malawi, Lilongwe, Blantyre. They have stretched their hands and they are being used as axis of regime change. It is for this note on this that on behalf of Pan-African Forum, an international lobby group which has lobbied on various things on Africa, including the International Criminal Court, against the International Criminal Court, against the ICJ involvement in the Constitutive Assembly arrangements of AU on boundaries, against sanctions on Zimbabwe, we want to state as the following. One, the time has come for us in Africa and the people of Zimbabwe to change the habit of begging United States to remove sanctions from Zimbabwe. Time has come for us not to beg, but time has come for us to tell the people of Zimbabwe to bust the sanctions. The word is bust the sanctions. B-U-R-S-T. Why are you begging United States to remove sanctions? Why should the United States control your livelihood? Why should the United States control the sale of your diamond, the sale of your gold, the sale of your copper, the sale of your resources when your people are dying? We want to call upon the government of Zimbabwe and the rest of Africa, the African Union, SADC, East Africa, IGAD, COMESA. We must bust the sanctions. Today marks a historical day for me personally. I'm a friend of the people of Zimbabwe. I struggled against Morgan Tsvangirai and his ilk. The professor who is still alive in Zimbabwe today pretending to be a leader of opposition, Tendai Biti. Professor Walshiman Kube, Ibo Madaza. These are the people I struggled against. From 1997 to date, I have stood against dark forces that have tried to dismember Zimbabwe. I have paid a high price for standing up for people of Zimbabwe. I've never discriminated anybody. But I have stood on the side of the truth that the people of Zimbabwe have a destiny. And their destiny is to allow them to sell their goods, their resources, the way they want. Today, I want to change this river that has been flowing every minute of removing sanctions, Ramaphosa. Chairperson calling on the United States to remove. Why? We don't need to beg them anymore. Ian Smith bust sanctions. Let the people of Zimbabwe listen to me today. Let Emmerson Mnangagwa, Your Excellency, General Chiwenga, Major General Simbisi Omoyo, the rest General Sibanda. Time has come to remove. We don't want to beg the United States again. Enough is enough. Let's bust the sanctions. Let Africa help you to bust the sanctions, to feed your people, to buy your medicine, to buy them food, to recreate a harmony in your society, to build your infrastructure which has been destroyed. You need to bust sanctions. Don't listen to Trump anymore. Don't listen to the ambassador of United States in America, of America in Zimbabwe. Useless. There's no need of begging these people anymore. Time has come for Africa to take a revolutionary stand, a radical stand, to make sure that Zimbabwe sells its goods, resources, to get money to service the industries, to build infrastructure, to buy textbooks for schools, to buy medicine for hospitals, without begging the United States of America. Enough is enough. For 18 years, groups, we have been begging these guys to remove sanctions. You have conducted elections. Some of them have been the most peaceful elections. You have had every accusation. You have begged America to remove sanctions from you. They have not agreed. Time has come to change the strategy. And this time is now. On behalf of Pan-African Forum, an international lobby group, I go ahead here in the international waters. I go ahead here to stand. I'm not a Zimbabwean, but I will begin to battle anybody standing on the way, anybody refusing Zimbabwe to sell its resources in order to buy food for its people, will be an enemy of the people of Africa. Time has come for us Africans to change the strategy on Zimbabwe, to help Zimbabwe to sell their resources, to give them the hard-earned currency, the needed currency in Zimbabwe to buy medicine, to supply them with medicine. Enough is enough of begging America. Time has come for the people of Africa to realize that George Soros has arrived on this continent. The recent events in Malawi will vindicate me. I have told you time and time, my people of Africa, that several countries in sub-Saharan Africa will undergo very serious and dangerous reforms. There are people in Africa who have sold our continent. One of them is Twaibu Masiyiwa. He sold the continent. He has the resources, but he doesn't help us. He instead helps the whites. He instead helps agencies. He instead undermines the integrity of the African people. Does he create this business for himself or for his people? You can't have money. They walk around, fly around all the cities of Africa, lecturing to us how rich you are when your country is dying. It's a shame. It's a great shame for the people of Africa. You can't have the money and you don't invest it in your own country, but you are busy working with Kofi Annan Foundation, George Soros, France, to topple governments. You can't have the money. You get the money from the same people of Zimbabwe, and you don't help them who are sinking on a daily basis. It's for this reason that for us today, call upon Pan-African Forum, the statement, you'll find it attached, call upon the government of Zimbabwe to change tactics, to bring in tough measures, to allow them not to beg America anymore, You have made it enough. You have stood, we have stood by you for 18 years. The enemy is not hearing us. The enemy has forgotten all about us. The people die on a daily basis. Yet you have your resources to serve. Someone enters your house, tells you that I don't want you to sell anything. It is yours. And he goes outside your house and puts a ban on you. Not to eat, not to have food, but to be called names. It is not the proper way that Africa should watch and sit and watch the people of Zimbabwe perish under sanctions. Pan-African Forum, United Kingdom Limited, calls upon all stakeholders in the diaspora, in Zimbabwe, in Africa, to stand up to help Zimbabwe to bust sanctions. I'm changing the mode. Remember the word you have been using, begging, begging, remove, remove sanctions. Who are you begging? Are these resources, resources of the people of America or resources of the people of Zimbabwe? Whether you are in MDC, whether you are in ZANU-PF, whether you are in whatever party you have, the resources belong to the people of Zimbabwe. America has no right to stand up to call upon the world not to allow Zimbabwe to trade in its minerals. America has no right to curtail Zimbabwe from trading with other partners. Yet the people in Zimbabwe are dying on a very huge scale because of medicine, textbooks. If we kill our children without textbooks in Zimbabwe, how will the future generation in Zimbabwe remain? I want America to tell me how this will help us. I respect the people of Zimbabwe. I have no quarrel. They can advocate for their democracy. But you eat democracy. How many people in America eat democracy? President Mnangagwa might not be able to speak. I'm speaking. All of us have been in a struggle. All of us paid for Zimbabwe's liberation. We have been soldiers. All of us. The entire Africa stood by Zimbabwe to have independence. My country, Uganda, paid a price. Other countries paid a price for the liberation of Zimbabwe. The younger men on Twitter and Facebook, you don't know yet that you cannot dismember Zimbabwe and we watch. You cannot be flying to Washington to tell them to put more sanctions, to beg, let's bust the sanctions. My call is to bust the sanctions. Those watching me in Harare, listen and read my mood. Let me remove the glasses so that you read my mood. Time has come to bust the sanctions. Ian Smith bust the sanctions. What are you waiting for? Don't beg America anymore. The other day I saw the Minister of Finance writing a letter begging America. That's silly. You are begging them to do what? They can't give you anything. You have your minerals to sell. Write a letter to ask them to leave you to sell your minerals, to get the money and bring it back to the people of Zimbabwe. Let's not have these hiccups of double standards. Let's not. Let's fight to remove not anymore to bust sanctions. Let's bust sanctions. America say, does not want to remove sanctions. Therefore, let's bust them. I will expose Hampton Bunyongwe for being part and parcel of the people regime changing Emmerson Mnangagwa. I have all the records, the money transfers, the engagements, the meetings with Jonathan Moyo and the others. The plot to destabilize Zimbabwe begins from there. If authorities in Zimbabwe don't work on it, we shall work on it as Pan-Africans. We have exposed Al-Shabaab in East Africa here. We have known who are the funders of Al-Shabaab. It's not difficult to know who Bunyongwe receives money from and what he does with it. Hampton, next time you appear around this region, we shall get you. Stay where you are. That's a serious one. Stop. We have evidence to nail you. George Soros is a misery for Africa. You are able to overturn a regime of Mutharika in Malawi. I know what you did there. But don't worry. We shall table it. We have followed you. Today is the day for us to speak as we have spoken. Tomorrow and the other day is for us to table facts. We want to warn those who want to tackle, who want to destabilize the people of Zimbabwe who are struggling to recover from the malaise of economic hardships created by sanctions to stop it. My statement means a lot. I've gathered quite a lot. We have followed who is who doing what. We are about, and we shall lay the facts before you and before the public and the world, what you have been doing against the people of Zimbabwe. Regime change is happening. As we speak today, Ethiopia is under a cloud of regime change. Security agencies are fighting crowds that have not left. As we speak today, Mali in Bamako, crowds have refused to leave. We want the people of Zimbabwe to unite, to use the model of friendship that was between President Uhuru Kenyatta and Raila Amolo Odinga in Kenya to improve the welfare of your country. Fragmenting yourselves in two pieces. I saw some men calling themselves green t-shirts, green what? That does not help you. You'll face the same problem. You'll face the same problem. Even if you change it today, you'll have the same problem of sanctions, unless you bust them. Unless you change the behavior of the American hegemon on the people of Zimbabwe. Change today does not mean anything if you have not liberated yourself by busting and telling Americans enough is enough. Chuba today is stunning. He told America, let's die of poverty, but we shall not give up and give in. Several countries have said so. You can't allow your people to die when you have your minerals to sell. And America doesn't want you to sell. America doesn't want you to have the dollar to buy your own people food. Surely, we can't go on and go on and go on like this. Finally, I want to thank the people of Africa. The researchers, my people in Zimbabwe, those who have researched, those who have helped, those who in the diaspora in London, who have got all these statements, who have gathered the money truck, the George Soros. We want to tell Strive Masiyiwa, Hapton Bonyongwe, Jonathan Moyo, and others who are hidden around the Sadaka countries, that we watch you every day. We know what you want to do. But first, think of the consequences. Why should you write to incite the public in Zimbabwe when you are in safety? In a land of safety, Jonathan, think of the consequences. The people of Zimbabwe want the infrastructure to improve. They want fuel. They want medicine. They want sugar. They want money. They want goods in there. Let's help them by busting sanctions. Let African countries start ferrying goods, giving Zimbabwe credit lines to fill the shops for the people of Zimbabwe. Let's bust the sanctions. Let's allow the trade of their minerals such that tomorrow Africa will stand, Zimbabwe will rise and shine again. I will continue to defend President Emmerson Mnangagwa. Sunshine, rain, I support both. All of them are my friends. General Chiwenga, I greet you. Major General Simbisiyo Moyo, I greet you. You know my stand, all of you. I have never betrayed an African cause. Don't be distracted. The root is there, unity. We are going to support you fully. Don't be distracted by this. Let's bust the sanctions. If Ian Smith could bust the sanctions, who are you? What are you waiting for? You have your minerals to sell. America is in big shit. It can't have ventilators. You have managed this COVID-19 properly, better than America. Stand up and be proud as Africans. Don't be intimidated. Stand and be proud. Don't divide yourselves into small factions. You got it, we shall support you. There are countries in Africa that want to support you. Thank you very much. God bless all of you. You'll find my statement on www.panafricanforumlotd.com. I repeat, www.panafricanforumlotd.com. My statement in full is there. Thank you very much. Thank you, the world. Thank you, the people of Zimbabwe. Thank you, the leadership of Zimbabwe. I am an international activist. My role is to voice out where I see there is inequality. My role is to stand to defend the voiceless. My role is to speak out when Africa is being squeezed. My role is to defend revolutions, the struggles of the founding fathers of this continent, Amir Kabura, Sekou Toure, Kwame Nkrumah, Patrice Lumumba, Julius Nyerere, Haile Selassie, Gabriel Nyanza, Samora Machel, Babata Fada Tawewa. My role is to stand, to support, to defend the spirit of the founding fathers, Dr. Milton Obote in Uganda, Jomo Kenyatta in Kenya. That's my role. To give you the impetus to stand to fight for your countries. The younger generation, don't be confused by money. You have seen that in COVID-19, all of us are helpless. There is no hospital in Germany open for an African. All of us are on the continent. We are stuck here. So money is not everything. Passion, patriotism, African nationalism, those three are the answers to our problems of this continent. Thank you.